Hi, my name is Sara Hallager. I'm a biologist at the Smithsonian's National Zoo. Here at the National Zoo, we have Caribbean flamingos. They are found throughout Mexico, the Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico, and throughout the Caribbean. Flamingos are very social animals. They live in flocks that number from a couple thousands to the millions. And so they seem to always be communicating with each other. Here at the zoo, they seem to talk all day long. I've come in at 3 in the morning and they're talking. I mean, they never seem to be quiet. We have been managing flamingos at the zoo pretty much for most of the zoo's history, but really most intensely over the past 20 years. And our flock now numbers at 61 birds. 20 years ago we were at about 20 birds, and the number has been built up through careful management. We are also now at the point where we are sending chicks and eggs out to other zoos. We manage our colony of flamingos during the breeding season for several reasons. One is that we want to be able to control reproduction of eggs. We obviously don't want brother-sister reproducing for genetic reasons, or mother-son, father-daughter, that sort of thing. And since our flock is, half the flock is captive-born, we obviously have some related birds in the flock. So before each breeding season starts, usually in April or May, we go out with a pair of binoculars and we're able to identify pairs. And we do that by looking at the bands on each of the flamingo's leg. We can't prevent a brother-sister, say, from pairing and laying an egg together, but what we can do is when that egg is laid, we can discard that and prevent, obviously inbred chick from hatching. Here at the zoo, when eggs are laid, they are taken from the parent. The parents are given what's called a dummy egg. The real egg is moved inside to an incubator set to 37.5 degrees centigrade, where it's warm, it's dry, it's totally protected, and it's safe. So when it's time for hatching, the egg is moved back outside under the parents. These are pairs that we've identified ahead of time as being good parents. What's interesting is that they may not necessarily have laid that egg, but by good incubation behavior, skills that we identify by watching them, signs that point to us that they are going to be good parents, we will put the egg back under the pair that we think is most successful in raising the chick. The average lifespan of flamingos in zoos is much longer than people probably realize. We have flamingos in the Smithsonian's National Zoo flock that have been here since the mid-60s, and those were wild-caught birds. So many, many flamingos can live well into their 50s. It's not uncommon at all.